Welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm going to be waving my hair today. It's been a while since I have used a wand to curl my hair. I was looking through some old pictures through the holidays and I saw my hair when I did it with a wand. At least I think it was with a wand. And so I want to do it again. I just blow dried my hair and it set to make sure it laid really nicely, because that's been one of my biggest problems lately, is I'll curl my hair but I feel like I didn't like blow dry it or like prep it for the curl, and then I'm not really loving the way the final result looks. And I didn't think it was really because of the way I curled it, it was just mainly because of the prep. The other day I did kind of cut some bangs into my hair, just a random idea, no rhyme or reason, I don't know, I just really wanted a little bit more face framing, so that's what I did. Wanding is pretty easy. You just wrap it around the wand and you make sure you don't burn your fingers during the process. One of the biggest tips I have for people when it comes to curling the hair, even if you use a regular normal curling iron without the clamp, you just wrap it around and then twist the wand to wrap it up and tighter to the head as you're going up, and then I always just hold for a few more seconds. I feel like it's a little bit thicker of strands typically, so you wanna hold it for a little bit longer. Typically that helps curl it a little bit stronger. I'm taking a little bit bigger sections here in the back, and I'm gonna burn myself. Then I just roll it up. I'll show it again on the other side. I'm just gonna do the back really quick, and then I'll be back. All right, so this is the way it looks in the back currently. It is so hard to use the wand on this short of hair. I was really struggling. So the tip that I was talking about, I'm just gonna show it one more time. So you take the hair, you wrap it around, but then you twist the wand as you're wrapping it around, and you see how it goes tighter to the head. Then you have a nice wrapped around surface, and it's as tight to the scalp as you can get. You can see the difference in the curl between the straight and the curled hair, and how curled I'm able to get it. See how far out it is from the head, and then I'm wrapping it in to get it tighter to the scalp. It doesn't, not a huge result change or anything, but it definitely helps, I think. Oh my God, burning my scalp. I'm gonna take my Beach Waver Second Chance. This is dry shampoo, but it's also, I really think this is much more of a texturizing spray, to be honest. I'm spraying that all over my scalp, right where the part is. I'm just gonna shake it in. I'm gonna go ahead and just take this top half down. I'm gonna split it into two sections. So I'm gonna pull this part forward, dry shampoo this section. Same thing, and I'm gonna brush this section out. So I am traveling tomorrow. So this is going to be my 5 a.m. hair done, but I am going out tonight as well for dinner. So it does have to look good tonight. Normally I wouldn't even brush it out or anything, but I am gonna have to do that this time. So I'm gonna keep it up, like clipped up, just so I don't have to find the section again. Just using bobby pins, so I don't have to like figure out where my section is, especially if you don't have like a double mirror or something. I would recommend doing that. I still have a lot of layers in the back. I'm really trying to grow them out. Kinda hate them, to be quite honest. So I'm trying to grow out those layers so I don't have to keep, oh my scalp, have to keep dealing with them. I feel like they get so tangly in the shower because they're so short. Like every time it's just like a mangled mess in the back, and my hair doesn't really like tangle that easily, so it's very weird that it's doing that, to be honest. This section I'm actually gonna split into fours. That looks weird. And then I'm gonna split this. Not the best, but it's getting the job done. So if you wanna know how long I'm holding it, because in the edit, I probably won't show it. Holding it for about 8 to 10 seconds. I just counted to see. I'm gonna do this twice actually as well. This is a really thick section. I'm gonna just hold my head like this and hope that that other section doesn't drop. So I'm holding it for about 8 to 10 seconds. I think that that's roughly the right amount of time for my thickness of hair. I feel like if you have really thick hair, you might want to do it a little bit longer. Or if you have hair that you feel like doesn't curl very well, you also might want to do it a tiny bit longer. But if you have like naturally curly hair, you probably don't have to hold it that long. And it also depends on the section. So I'm supposed to do all of this in like under 20 minutes because we're supposed to leave. And I just don't know if that's gonna happen. If filming a video and curling your hair all in 20 minutes, that's the challenge. Oh, so that's pretty good. I like filming for not a long amount of time. It's a lot easier to edit, not as much footage to go through. If you notice in my channel, I really don't like super long videos. I feel like people's attention spans are very short these days, so I try and keep them under. A lot of beauty videos seem to be on the longer side, like in the industry, but I just don't think they have to be. Okay, so the back is completely done. I'm just gonna finish off with the sides. Because the rest are really thick sections, thicker in the back, I'm gonna stay with that same thickness so it's consistent all the way around. Same technique here in the front, but instead of doing all one side at a time, I'm gonna go back and forth. Because again, I want it to be nice and consistent. I've actually never done this before, going back to back. Normally I do all one side. But I just feel like this is a little bit more consistent because the problem is they'll get tired after doing one side, then the other side I don't care about, or vice versa. I feel like I'm not giving myself enough time on one side, then one side looks better. So I just want it to be nice and consistent, so that's why I'm doing it this way. So you're gonna see as I come around, I try and keep the hair strand flat. You can see I'm smoothing it out with my fingers as it comes around instead of letting it twist. This also helps create a better curl because it will look a lot more like twistier waves instead of like the ribbon waves as you're seeing here. I can show you the difference. So if you do it like this and just wrap around, it's not gonna be smooth. You can see how it's twisted right here. And when you let it down, see how it looks different. And we don't want it to look like that. Again, it's all about consistency. So just taking it, wrapping it around, making it nice and smooth instead of turning with the curl. Unless you want it to look twisty, but you're gonna have to do that on every single curl and make sure it looks like that. So one thing about like wanding, and I also think people struggle for doing flat iron curls, is it's not consistent. I'm just gonna do the bangs really quick. Again, nice flat curls. I don't like my bangs like super curled, but at the same time, you have to remember if you don't hold it on there as long, it's not gonna be as tight up curls. And then it might be longer than the rest. All right, I'm gonna let these cool. I'm gonna do my makeup really quick. And then I'm gonna finish off with some hairspray. I'm probably gonna end up brushing out my hair, but we'll see. I'll be back in just a few. To look at the back like this. I've never seen my hair so curly. I forgot how curly wand curls are, like literally. We're gonna have to use clips for this dinner party. There's a couple pieces in the back though that I don't think are as curly. So I'm just gonna do a couple pieces. Can't believe I'm saying this, but curlier. But basically what I'll do when I wake up tomorrow is just brush it out, actually brush it out completely. And then go from there. It's been 23 minutes. I'm over my time. Okay, since it is so hard to get that bottom section, I'm actually gonna take my clamper and just curl this little bottom section. The point of doing this is because I don't want this to be visible. So I just want it a little bit curlier. A little crazy. We're gonna let it cool. I'm gonna get this front looking good. I'm basically just kind of rotating this over and letting the bottom of my hair kind of do its own thing. curls are just speaking for themselves today. I think the back looks really good. Let's check it. This is the final look. It was not done in 20 minutes, but that's okay. Everything is turned off, so we are good to go. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.